Hey again, everybody. It's Danny, Senior Analytical Training Consultant here at SAS, back one more time to talk about custom steps. Now, what have we accomplished so far and been interrupted so far? We've planned the custom step that we wanted to create. We talked about some of the ideas you need to be taking into consideration as to what object would work well with different pieces of your code that you're interested in making into a custom step. We then created the GUI. We actually built it piece by piece, and we've got it looking nice. And then we connected the program code in the back to the user interface by using those IDs. Remember, those became our macro variables that we referenced. Remember I told you, be very careful what you name them. Make sure you remember what they are, because it will come back inside of the program code itself. So there's only one last thing we really need to discuss. How in the world do you use your new custom step? So join me, I'll show you how. Now, the first way that you can utilize a custom step is inside of something that is called a flow. Now, the flow, for those that might have a flashback seeing this, you might think of process flow from SAS Enterprise Guide. I would be thinking that direction myself too. Again, it's called a flow. That was called a process flow. Now, what's going to happen here is that we're going to basically kind of diagrammatically show what we're doing in this approach of how we're putting everything together. Now, to start things off in this flow, I'm just going to add into my flow two basic tables. Now, you yourself can actually connect and drag and drop your own data sets from the libraries on this left-hand side here into here if you actually have a data set you would like to utilize with the custom step. But I'm just going to click on add here, and I'm just going to bring in a couple of tables. Now I'm going to actually connect in and drag in the actual custom step that we made. So in the SAS steps area, you'll notice that there's SAS steps. Now, these are the ones that SAS created for you, and it's part of your release and the licensing that you have. But once you start creating your own custom steps and you start saving them, you're gonna notice that they'll be in this shared territory. So this is the one that we've created. So I'm just going to drag and drop it right into the flow. Now, one thing that I want you to notice, remember that we, in our actual custom step, created an input data table and an output data table connection. Do you see the box on the left and the box on the right? The box on the left is where you will connect a table to your custom step to be the input data set. The right box is where you will connect to an output data table that we're going to use for this custom step. So I'm going to just organize myself by putting things to the left and to the right. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to drag an arrow to the left and drag an arrow from the box to the right side table. And now I've officially told the step who's the input data set and who's the output data set. Now, a couple things I want to let you know. What if you created a custom step that had two input data sets or two output data sets that you would need to basically make sure you don't mix up? Point at one of those boxes. You may notice a nice little pop-up appeared. Do you remember how I told you that the ID is extremely important? Guess what? That pop-up that you just saw come into here is the ID name of the data set that you put into your actual step. So if you do have two inputs, two outputs, and you don't know which one to connect to where, point at the boxes and it will show you the ID. And as long as you've named the ID to make sense, you'll know exactly where to connect. Now, what about all of those objects that we created for our custom step. Where in the world are they? Well, if you click on and select the custom step in the flow, you look down here at the bottom, I'll bring this up so we can see it a little bit better. Check it out. There's our data and options tabs, pages. Wait a minute, Danny, the data tab is selected, but I don't see the object for the input data set. And Danny, I don't see the output page where we selected the output data set. Did something go wrong? No. Haven't you already in the flow told your step who's the input data set and who's the output data set? So those items are not present in the flow version. Now, since the output page, output tab, only had that one object, the entire page disappeared. If that output page had any other objects on it, that page would still be there. But the selection of the output data set would be gone because you've already done it. But everything else is right here. What are your categorical variables? What are your continuous variables? Checkboxes, everything along those lines. Right here, ready to go. Once you have your input data set ready, you've got your output data set ready, everything is good to go, you click run. And your custom step is now executing. But I said that there's more than one way to get a custom step to execute. Here is where we have a flashback to our tasks of our past. Check this out. When you're looking at the custom step area or the step area inside of SAS Studio, and you have your list of all the custom steps that you've created, if instead of dragging and dropping into a flow, if I right click on that actual custom step we made and I say open in a tab, what you're going to see very quickly, I'll hide that left side. Doesn't that look like a task? The structural setup that you see right now is exactly like a task, but notice who's back. Select table for analysis is in the data page. Select location of the output table is in the output page. Why? You're not running it in a flow. It doesn't know who the input and output data sets are because of the connections on the flow. Here, you have to tell it everything. Just like you did in a task. And again, make all of your decisions. The run button will become accessible and you execute your custom step. Either way will be fine. So guess what, everybody? That's it. We have gone from the full spectrum of getting started and trying to decide what type of a custom step we're going to do, all the way through the creation of that custom step to the very end with how to run it. So, what custom steps would you like to try to make? Let us know down in the comments. What's your favorite types of procedures that you think would work great with a custom step? Hey, your favorites may be the favorites of others. Or you might give some people some other ideas. So feel free to share. You know where to put that. Also, don't forget, we've been broken into multiple videos because of someone else that keeps interrupting us. Check out those links. Make sure that if you want to go back and see any of the previous parts of this storyline for how to create a custom step, please go back and look. That way you can make sure that you understand all of the aspects of how you can put together these custom steps. Also, check out those links for accessibilities to other pieces of information that might be of benefit to you. So, on behalf of myself and myself, thanks so much for joining us in this nice little series. And again, remember to like and subscribe. Take care.